So here are most of my models for the gathering. The only one that's missing is the universal off-roader, but you already seen that one, the black one. First, let's start with, actually, let's start with the smallest ones. So this is the mini trail truck. It has four-wheel drive, four-wheel steering, and it has pendular suspension. Both axles can steer, so front and rear wheel steering, so it has a very tight steering radius. I'm using one power functions L motor for driving and one powered up L motor for steering and a single BuWizz 3.0. And this is also very interesting because I'm using a very different drive system as usual. The drive to the axles doesn't come from this side as usual, but the drive actually comes from the top. There is a CV joint hidden here and the drive comes from the top. This way I avoid the torque of the axles trying to twist the suspension. So this is the mini trail truck. It has around 400 pieces. Next we have a mini racer. This is around 720 pieces. It's powered by two BuWizz motors in the back. The BuWizz 3.0 controlling it is placed in the front, so we have a very good weight distribution. So we have a heavy BuWizz in the front and two heavy motors for driving in the back. A powered up L motor can be seen here. This is for the steering. And this also has four-wheel drive. And each motor drives one side. So we have left and right side independent drive. So this is a very maneuverable model. And I geared it so it's a bit slower, but it has more torque because we need the torque when we're driving on foam. It's much more important than top speed, in my opinion. And if we open the doors, there's a full interior with two seats. And actually, if you steer the wheels, you can actually see the steering wheel turn. So this is one of the most functional and detailed models I built at this scale. And it's my first one with the actual working steering wheel. So I'm really happy how it turned out. And one detail, last detail is you can open the front to turn on and off the BuWizz. And you can easily access the charging port here in the front. So that's the mini racer. Then the Audi, well, this you already seen this video. Basically, it's the modification of the Audi using BuWizz motors, and it's recolored in typical BuWizz red color. And finally, the 1 to 10 scale SUV. I used the Lamborghini LM002 as my base reference. I, as usually, downloaded the 3D model and used it in Lego Digital Designer as a 3D reference. It has a two-speed gearbox and four-wheel drive. This is the slow gear. And this is the fast gear. So four-wheel drive, independent suspension on all four wheels, working steering wheel. We can open the boot, we can open all the doors, and of course we can open the engine bay. And inside the engine bay you will find a bit oversized V12. You can also grab it by the roof and just see how the engine works. And yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out. 2,851 pieces. Lots of details, and this is actually my first model that uses these tires from the Tumbler. They were the most fitting for this type of vehicle, and it is very capable. It has plenty of torque to spin the wheels here on rough asphalt, and it can go quite fast. It only uses two BuWizz motors and one BuWizz 3.0 as per rules/regulations, and all the motors and everything are hidden here in this section where the fuel tank usually is. So if we open the doors and we can tilt the seat, and here you will see a small axle sticking out. This is for turning on and off the BuWizz, and you can also charge it here. And basically all the electronics are here. So this was a very tight fit. On this side, on the right side, we have a BuWizz behind the seats, and on the left side there is a powered up medium motor which is used for shifting the gears. If you look on the bottom, everything is nicely protected, so there are no exposed gears, so I can go over grass and stuff with no problems. And because the rear is heavier than the front, I'm using two shock absorbers, two hard ones in the rear, and one soft and one hard in the front, because the front is lighter. So this is my model for the gathering, and we'll see how it works.